Happy Holidays from Channel 2. From Channel 2 Sports, it's Warner Wolf's Plays of the Year. Warner Wolf's Plays of the Year is sponsored by TWA. You're going to like us. And by the American Express card. Don't leave home without it. Now here's Warner.
All right, welcome to this Saturday night, the last Saturday night of the year. And I'd like to thank you and our sponsors, bringing back popular demand, the next 30 minutes, the plays of the year of 1984. We'll also have our sportsmanship award, many baseball brawls this year, and wrestling highlights. So, here we go now for the first half of the plays of the year of 1984, from January to June. Let's go to the videotape. Here we go. First of all, the longest shot of the month, Dwayne Washington of Syracuse. There it goes, 46-footer swish. The longest NBA shot of the year, Magic Johnson, Lakers, 55-footer, good. The best touchdown pass in the NBA and the stuff, it's Moses Malone to Julius Erving in the stuff. The best dive into the stands for a loose ball, you remember this? Michael Okorn of the Nets, come back, Mike. The most alert owner watching his own team play, Ted Turner of the Atlanta Hawks. Come on, give us a break, Ted. Certainly the best hockey fight of the month in January, Mike Foligno of the Sabres in the blue, and Luke DeFore of the Bruins. The best infighting of two football linemen, Lawrence Pillows of the 49ers and Russ Grimm of the Redskins. The best move by a basketball coach who thought he was robbed by the referees, New Orleans' Don Smith. In February, the most unusual shot of the month, Greg Trapp of Oregon falling over the baseline, swish. The longest shot of the month in February, Phil Ford, Houston, 70-footer, swish into your living room. The best fast break, Theus to Higgins to Theus to Greenwood, who puts it in. The best brawl of the month, Lonnie Shelton of Cleveland and Buck Williams of the Nets. Two Giants go at it. The car crash of the month. It was Randy LaJoy. Remember this? Dayton time trials. Loses control 190 miles an hour. Released and okay after 3 days in the hospital. The punch of the month, Jihad Kareem. Left hand, here it comes, and boom. In March, the best touchdown pass in an NBA game, the Nets, Darrell Dawkins to Michael Ray Richardson. The best thrown ball by a player. Boom, Pat Cummings hits Bill Walton. The fastest goal from the opening faceoff, Brian Trottier, 5 seconds into the game, ties the National Hockey League record. The best collision, Timmy Higgins of the Devils, boom, Peter Anderson of the Capitals. The best golf shot of the month, Tom Kite, third round Doral Open, 14th hole, 165-yard shot in the cup. The best flip of the month, Tom Donovan, Philadelphia Stars. Best catches of the month of April by center fielders, Chet Lemon of the Tigers, robbing Lenny Fiedo. Rudy Law of the White Sox, who robs Cal Ripken Jr. Look at this grab. All right. George Wright of Texas, robbing Roy Smalley, then of the Yankees. The best show business play by a shortstop, Ozzie Smith of the Cardinals, behind the back flip. Best fake pitch, John Denny of the Phillies, who slips on the mound. The best teamwork on one catch, Texas Rangers, Wayne Tolleson to Larry Parrish. The best leapfrog of the month, Buddy Bell of the Texas Rangers. And out at the plate. The best bounce pass of the month, Jeff Houston to Paul Thompson. The biggest brawl of the month, Quebec and Montreal, 252 minutes in penalties, 11 players ejected. In May, the best catch by center fielder, Al Bumbrey, the Orioles. The best catch by two players after a collision, Ron Hassey and Pat Tabler of Cleveland. The best play by a second baseman fielding the ball that hits the bag, Willie Randolph of the Yankees. The best reaction by a pitcher, on a ball hit back to the mound. Mark Thurman, who loses his glove, goes after the ball and throws him out. Worst catches of May, Davey Lopes of the A's. Then we had Juan Benitez of the Angels. Good grab, Juan. Best somersault by a center fielder, Phil Bradley of Seattle. The best disappearing act by a right fielder going into the stands, Mike Brown of the Angels. Up, over, and disappears. The best high five by a player to an umpire while scoring a run, Joe Morgan of the A's. The worst attempt by a fan getting a ball. Come on, boo, give that fan a break. In May, the best basketball brawl of the month, Celtics and the Knicks. Danny Ainge, Celtics, Darryl Walker, Knicks, Ainge and Walker, fine. The foul of the month, Roy Sparrow of the Knicks, Larry Bird of the Celtics. The best golf shot in May, Peter Jacobson, 18th hole. Final round Memorial Tournament, third shot, par 4, 100-yard shot. Good, and that was not a trick shot, folks. In June, the best catch by sliding right fielder in foul territory, Claudel Washington. The best play by a shortstop going into the hole, Johnny LeMaster of the Giants. The best catch by a pitcher in self-defense, Mike Kruko of the Giants. The worst catch by a pitcher in self-defense, Juan Berenguer of the Tigers. Hit by the ball, but fortunately, continued the game. The worst throw by a first baseman to an empty base, Jason Thompson of the Pirates. Nice throw, Jason. The collision of the month, Mike Easler of the Red Sox, and boom, catcher Bob Carney of Seattle. Worst base running following a double to left field, Juan Samuel of the Phillies. Here he comes, nice move, Juan. The worst pitch of the month, Aurelio Lopez, who thought he was pitching to Wilt Chamberlain. The foul of the month, Kevin McHale, clotheslines, Kurt Rambis of the Lakers. The punch of the month, Thomas Hearns, right hand. Here it comes, wind up, and boom, apparently ending the career of Roberto Duran and ending the first half of our Plays of the Year from January to June. Before part two, Plays of the Year, coming up, many baseball brawls in 1984.
Welcome.
This fall, TWA's got great deals all over Europe, like London, with hotels as low as $10 a night and a car for a week free. Welcome.
Do you know me? It's frightening how many novels of suspense I've written. But still, when I'm not recognized, it just kills me. So instead of saying I wrote Carrie, I carry the American Express card. Without it, isn't life a little scary?
To apply for the card, look for an application and take one.
The American Express card. Don't be fooled without it.
Seems like there was an unusual number of brawls in baseball during the year 1984. So let's go to the videotape and let's look at some of them. Here we go. The Braves and Padres. Remember this? Pascal Perez hits Alan Wiggins. In the next inning, Ed Whitson throws inside to Perez. Two innings later, Whitson again throws at Perez. Whitson and manager Dick Williams are ejected. Craig Lefferts then throws at Perez. Lefferts is ejected. Here come the rest of the Braves. Perez walks away, but Champ Summers, later fined and suspended, tries to get at Perez, but is stopped by Bob Horner. The fans throw beer on Summers. Five fans are arrested at the game. Ninth inning, Donnie Moore hits Nettles. Nettles then comes after Moore. Moore and Nettles are fined, along with Joe Torre. Then we had another one. Seattle and the Angels. Brian Clark throws inside to Rod Carew. Rick Burleson, the Angels, then attacks Clark. Another brawl occurred between the White Sox and A's. Rich Dotson hit 6'6", 215-pound Dave Kingman. Kingman was ejected. Then we had the Yankees in Toronto. Dennis Rasmussen throws inside to Willie Upshaw. Upshaw went after Rasmussen, both ejected from the game. Then we had another one involving the Yankees. Yankees Angels. Ray Fontenot hit Juan Beniquez, each suspended 3 days. And it even spread to the minor leagues. Tidewater against Maine, Triple-A ball. Tidewater, Tim Leary, hits Maine's Dwight Taylor, and the brawl goes on. Taylor then got up, okay, and chased Leary out of the ballpark. In the next inning, Ramon Romero hit Tidewater's John Christensen, and they went at it. Well, are the batters too quick to fly off the handle after being hit by a pitch, taking inside pitches? We asked the great Willie Mays about being dusted off in his day.
I think it was accepted more because Drysdale knocked me down, Bob Gibson, Sam Jones, Bob Rush, but we always felt that was a compliment. They didn't knock down the 250 hitter, the 215 hitter. They knocked down the guys that wasn't going to hit them. My only thing that satisfied me, when a guy knocked me down, and if I hit a home run out of the ballpark, hey, that's telling me, knock me down again. You get the same thing.
All right, you tell him, Willie. Now, we've all seen ball players or managers give an umpire a piece of the mind. But between innings of a Phillies-Astros game this year, umpire Frank Pulley, upset at being yelled at by the Phillies, had this to say to the Phillies bench. Frank Pulley. Pulley ejected Sixto Lescano and a Phillies coach. Now, there were also a lot of major individual records broken this season, and here are some of them. Let's go to the videotape. First of all, Kareem with this hook against the Jazz broke Wilt Chamberlain's career record, became the NBA's all-time leading scorer, over 31,400 points and still climbing. Pete Rose, with this base hit off Jerry Kuzman, became only the second man in baseball history to have 4,000 hits in a career. 19-year-old Dwight Gooden, with this strikeout against Marvell Wynn, became the leader in most strikeouts in 1 year by a rookie pitcher. Walter Payton, in this game against the Saints, broke Jimmy Brown's all-time career rushing record, although many people will point out that Jimmy Brown did it in less games. Doug Flutie, in this game against Army, became the all-time leading passer in total yardage in college football. Dan Marino, with this touchdown pass against the Raiders, broke the record for most touchdown passes in 1 year and wound up with 48, also winding up with a record over 5,000 yards passing. Eric Dickerson, with this run against the Oilers, broke O.J. Simpson's record for most rushing yardage in 1 year, although it did take him more games than it took O.J. And Martina Navratilova broke Chris Everett's record of 56 straight singles matches, winning them, and she went on to win 74 in a row before losing to Helena Suková. Some of the major individual records set in 1984. All right, we'll be right back with some of your favorite wrestlers and also our Sportsmanship of the Year award.
You don't have to be a star, baby, to be in my show.
Welcome.
Bienvenue.
Welcome.
Welcome.
This fall, TWA's got great deals all over Europe, like London, with hotels as low as $10 a night and a car for a week free. Welcome.
Vous me connaissez, pourtant vous connaissez ma musique. Et quand je chante, vous reconnaissez ma voix, j'espère. Mais quand je voyage en France ou ailleurs, je ne peux jamais payer avec des. Alors, pour être traité comme, j'utilise la carte American Express.
To apply.
apply for the card, pick up an application.
Carte American Express, surtout ne partez pas sans elle.
For the second year in a row, our sportsmanship award goes to, you've got it, John McEnroe, this year for his manner displayed in the Swedish Open in Stockholm. Let's go to the videotape, and here's John. Serving, bottom of your screen.
It's fine. Right on the line. No mistakes so far in this match, right? You haven't overruled anything. No mistakes whatsoever.
Second stop, please.
Answer my question! The question, jerk!
Behavior, McEnroe was fined $2,100 and suspended 21 days. Hit it, John. Two strikes. Wait a minute. Come on. One more time. Boom, he's got it. The point is, there's nothing wrong with questioning the officials. But to belittle another human being while you're doing it is way out of bounds. Boo on John. All right, there were some outstanding wrestling matches this year, including many of your favorites. So let's go to the videotape, and here they are. Bring them on. Dusty Rhodes against the Assassin. Do it, Dusty. That's it. Wow. Hulk Hogan against Greg Valentine. Boom. A delayed fall. Sergeant Slaughter against Dick Murdoch and Adrian Adonis. Two for the price of one. The hungriest wrestler of the year, George the Animal Steel, eating the ring padding. Worst grudge match of the year, Sergeant Slaughter winding up and hitting the Iron Sheik. The Wild Samoan and Dick Murdoch. Samoan says, what are you doing? No, this is how you do it. Boom. The new wrestler of the year, Brutus Beefcakes in the zebra pants. Bring him on. Women wrestlers, Princess Victoria against Peggy Lee. Ooh. Most consecutive kicks imitating Fred Astaire, Akita Naida. Rocky Johnson against Dr. D. David Schultz. And Superfly Snuka and the Wild Samoan. All right, we'll be back with our second half of the plays of the year of 1984 from July to December in just a moment.
This fall, TWA's got great deals all over Europe, like London, with hotels as low as $10 a night and a car for a week free. Welcome.
You may know my do-wack-a-do-wack-a-do-wack-a-do-wack-a-do, but my do-wack-a-do don't do me no good when I'm traveling, so I just got myself an American Express card, and that makes me the king of the road.
To apply for the card, look for an application and take one.
The American Express card. Don't leave home without it.
All right, it's time now for the second half of the plays of the year 1984 from July to December. So let's go to the videotape. Here we go. First of all, in July, the best catch by a right fielder with his back to the plate, Sixto Lescano of the Philadelphia Phillies. The worst catch by two outfielders on one routine fly ball, Timmy Raines and Andre Dawson of the Expos. The longest golf shot of July by a woman, Hollis Stacey, 13th hole ladies PGA, 123-yard shot, the ball rolls in. The best effort by a race car driver, Nigel Mansell, Dallas Grand Prix, trying to push his car across the finish line. The crash of the month in which the driver was unhurt, Poncho Carter, Michigan 500. In August, the best catch by a center fielder against the fence, Dwayne Murphy of the A's. Come on, Dwayne. The weirdest double play of the month, Pete Rose, line drive off Lee Smith's shoulder. To Dave Owen, to Leon Durham, double play, game's over. Worst catch of the month by a left fielder, Jeff Stone of the Phillies. He's got it right, wrong. Worst catch by a center fielder, Candy Maldonado of the Dodgers. The most upset pitcher of the month after being taken out of the game, Pat Zachary of the Dodgers. The most upset manager of the month, Pat Corrales of the Indians, fined $1,000 or $250 per bat. Best argument of the month, Yankee manager Yogi Berra and umpire Joe Brinkman. Kick it, Yogi. Do it, Joe. The best reaction to sinking a putt, Chi-Chi Rodriguez, Hartford Open. There it is. The best improvisation by a tennis player, Brian Teacher, who uses his hand. In September, best catch by two fielders on one play, Scott Fletcher to Ron Kittle. The worst beer shower of the month, Juan Beniquez of the Angels. Cool off, Juan. The best local brawl with a pitcher throwing his glove at the batter, Ray Fontenot and Juan Beniquez. The best college football catch of the month, Glenn Kozlowski of Brigham Young. Look at that grab. The best fluke touchdown catch of the month, off the foot of defensive back Kenny Easley. And into the hands of Bobby Duckworth. Touchdown, Chargers. The punch of the month, Pina Fiza. Watch this right hand, boom. Down goes Gary Lightbourne. The best move by a tennis player during the match, Jimmy Connors, US Open. Take a break, Jimmy. The worst pitch of the month, Aurelio Lopez of the Tigers. Hits umpire Larry Barnett as catcher Lance Parrish moves out of the way. The best run of the month with only one shoe on. Keith Byers, Ohio State, 5 touchdowns against Illinois, including this 67-yarder. The worst sportsmanship award without a penalty. Don Smith of the Falcons rips off the helmet of William Roberts of the Giants. The best field goal kicked into a trash bag. Jim Breach of the Bengals, bullseye into the bag. The best move by a player jumping offsides and then getting back with no penalty. Jeff Apodaca, New Mexico University. The best reaction by a goalie after giving up a goal. Kings goalie Steve Janicek. Hit that bar, Steve. Hit it. Boom. Worst case of two players ganging up on one player. Pelly Lindbergh and Dave Brown of the Flyers pick on Rangers goalie Glenn Hanlon. The punch of the month, Rodney Frazier, left hand, down goes Michael Sam. In November, the shot of the month, Mark Aguirre, Dallas, 70-footer, swish. The longest shot after the buzzer, Celtics' Dennis Johnson, 55-foot hook shot, and it is good, but no good because it's after the buzzer. The dunk of the month, Michael Jordan of the Bulls. The best move of the month between two men, Charles Barkley of the 76ers. The brawl of the month, what else? 76ers Celtics, a total of 17 players, plus Billy Cunningham, fined $30,500. Julius and Bird, fined $7,500 and ejected. Worst aim of a water bottle in the penalty box, Wayne Gretzky. The best finish to a college football game in November, the last play of the game, Boston College trailing Miami by 4 points, Doug Flutie, 64 yards in the air, touchdown, Gerald Phelan, and Boston College wins. The human spinning wheel, Nat Moore, the Miami Dolphins. The hit of the month, Doki Williams of the Raiders, kickoff return, and boom, hit by Fred Young of Seattle. The worst human wave attempt of the month by two fans in Buffalo. The punch of the month, Juan Kidd Meza. Watch the left hand, boom, down goes Jaime Garza, fights over first round. Low blow of the month, Alex Ramos, blue trunks, left hand, fouls James Kitchen. The worst case of hitting after the bell, Tony Anthony, who hits Mike Weaver and is immediately disqualified after the first round. In December, the best elbow of the month, Xavier McDaniel of Wichita State, hitting Rick Osborne of Oregon. Boo! The best missed dunk, Charles Barkley of the 76ers. The best one-handed rebound and touchdown pass, Julius Erving to Andrew Toney. Worst interference of a man waiting for a punt. Elvis Patterson hit Stump Mitchell. Best razzle dazzle on the last play of the half. Intercepted Darryl Meadows to Bo Eason. Eason to Thompson. Thompson says, I don't want it. Back to Eason. That's the way it is. And Frank Field's dog was at the game. That's it, the plays of the year for 1984. I'd like to thank my staff, in particular, Carmine Sincotta, Cliff Gelb, Tony DiGiovanni, Doug Rabiner, George Seda, and Gary Goldstein. This is Warner Wolf wishing you a very happy and healthy new year.
Warner Wolf's Plays of the Year have been sponsored by the American Express Card. Don't leave home without it. And by TWA. You're going to like us. Us at Channel 2 Sports, our best wishes for a happy and healthy new year. Channel 2 News Newswatch with Randall Pinkston.
The Giants and all of New York's Super Bowl dreams will have to wait until next year. The San Francisco 49ers put that dream to sleep, beating the Giants 21-10. A three-year-old boy safely back home with his parents tonight after a man held the child hostage four frightening hours. At Gracie Mansion, the Guardian Angels demanded temporary amnesty for the subway vigilante.
Burger King presents eight simple words that can change your life.
I'll never eat a fry.
Go to Pandora
again.
Eight simple words, and you're on your way to Burger King for one of our double burgers. A quarter pound of beef, flame broiled, not fried. Quarter pound double hamburger, double cheeseburger, or bacon double cheeseburger. America, you never have to eat a fried quarter pounder again.
Never.
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 This has been Channel 2 Newswatch. Updated news at 11.
You've all heard me say that one of the greatest events in Nissan history is happening right now. I mean the Nissan Truck Challenge. That extra shipments of trucks have been sent to every Datsun dealership. And that they've been challenged by Nissan to move every one of their trucks before the end of the month. That should mean big savings, right?
Right!
What are you looking for?
King Cab.
And you?
Four by, what else?
They're all here. Sport trucks, long beds. It's the amazing Nissan Truck Challenge. If you ever wanted to buy a truck,
be at your nearby New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut Nissan Datsun dealers early for the best selection.
Lost 8 pounds.
Lose eight more.
Eight.
Everybody's got a diet, right? It doesn't matter who you are. It's gonna be a tough fight. So give yourself the greatest
taste.
Come on and put the fun back on your face.
Diet right, salt free. I'm avoiding salt and sodium.
Lee, I'm impressed.
She's impressed.
Everybody's got a diet, right?
The women love him.
I can't dispute that.
The bad guys hate him. The cops are somewhere in between.
Let's face it, every time you get lucky and you solve one of these dead cases, it makes us look stupid.
But everyone's after the ever-charming James Garner.
You've got two contacts at the mute.
I'm terrified.
Don't miss The Rockford Files, weekdays at 4, only on Channel 2.
Really?